Hi, I'm Cindy Love, and I'm here on this beautiful day in North Groton, New Hampshire, to introduce you to the sites that played a role in Mary Baker Eddy's life during the 5 years she lived here with her second husband, Daniel Patterson. Mary and Daniel moved here in 1855 when she was 34 to be near her 11-year-old son, George Glover, who was living with a foster family on a farm about a mile from here. They borrowed money from her sister to buy this little house on the bank of Hall's Brook. The house was built around 1820 on the foundation of what had been a grist mill in the mid-1700s. The landscape looked vastly different in the mid-1850s. There were over 750 people living in the North Groton area, and most of the land had been cleared of trees for lumber and farmland. At the time the Pattersons lived here, a small lane ran from the road through this grassy area in front of the house. Today, the setting for this little house looks idyllic, but when Mary and Daniel lived here, there was a sawmill directly across from the house, set at the end of this stone wall. The wall formed one side of the mill race that funneled water from the mill pond to power the mill wheel. Imagine what it would be like to have all this noise and activity right outside your front door, especially if you were unwell, as Mary often was. Daniel had part ownership in the mill, which sadly was not profitable. We're now looking at schoolhouse number 4, where Mary's son George went to school. It's less than a quarter of a mile up the road from Mary's house, in the heart of the village. The school was built in 1840, and students from the age of 4 to 20 were all taught at the same time in one room. The building is now home to the Groton Historical Society. And just around the corner from the school was the North Groton Union Meeting House, also built in 1840, and which served several denominations. Mary attended church here when she was well enough and was often invited to lead the congregation in prayer. She especially loved the 91st Psalm, and it's easy to imagine these verses from that psalm as a basis for her prayer, both here and at home. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him will I trust. Because Thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation, there shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For He shall give His angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. Unfortunately, the church building was destroyed during the severe winter of 1967 and 68 under the weight of heavy snow. Longyear now maintains the site and has placed this monument here that speaks of its connection to Mary Baker Eddy. What is now called Old Rumney Road once led from North Groton to Rumney and is likely the route through the village that Mary would have taken when she and Daniel needed to move from here to Rumney in 1860. Thanks for taking a peek at these sites with me. When you can, come and take a tour of the house and learn what happened here.